Bless you in Jesus' name. God bless you. God bless you in the name of Jesus. Amen. We give him the praise. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. I'm better, so much better, Lord. Oh yes, Lord, we give you praise. I'm stronger, I'm wiser, I'm better. Yes, we give you praise, Jesus. Amen. Give him the praise. Give him the praise. Give him the praise. I'm stronger, Lord. I'm wiser, Lord. I'm better, Lord. Much better, Lord. Much better, Lord. I made it, Lord. I made it, Lord. Oh, thank you, Jesus. We give you praise. We give you praise, Jesus. Without you, never would have made it without you. Oh, thank you, Jesus. I could never have made it without you, Lord. We could never have made it without him, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We give you the praise. We give you the praise. Amen. I'm stronger.
Now I'm wiser.
I'm better than ever.
So much better,
Lord.
I made it. Is there anybody in this house other than me that could declare you made it? Tell your neighbor, never would have made it.
Never would have made it. Never would have made it without you.
Oh, I wish I had some help here. I wish I had just two or three people that would just declare it. Never would have made it.
Never would have made it.
Never could have made it.
Never would have made it without you. Lord, thank you, Jesus. I could never have made it without you, Lord. You could never have made it without Jesus. Only Jesus can pull you through, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We give you praise. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus, we give you all the praise, we give you all the glory, we magnify your name, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, we give you praise. Hallelujah. Amen. We bless you, Lord Jesus, we give you the glory. Kings, we give you praise. Oh, come on and sing with me and worship God. We give him the praise.
He's patient. Love is kind.
Hallelujah. Favored me, Lord. My enemies, Lord, couldn't triumph over me. They couldn't triumph over me. They conspired. They did everything they wanted to do. But God favored me. God favored you. The enemy conspired. Amen. Come on and rejoice and sing with me. Hallelujah. God favored me. They whispered. They conspired. God favored me. My integrity, Lord. God favored me. Amen. God favored me.
I speak prosperity,
Lord. Oh yeah. God favored me. They whispered. They conspired against me. They told lies against me. But God favored me. Ooh. My character, Lord. My integrity, Lord. Ooh. God favored me. Hallelujah, Jesus. They whispered against you, but the favor of God came in upon your life. Ah, hallelujah, Jesus. God favored me. Yeah, yeah. God favored me. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Give him the praise. Give him the praise. Amen. God favored me. Yes, they will attack your character. They will attack your integrity. But I pray the Lord will favor you. God favor me. Yeah, 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 yeah. God favored me. Yeah, yeah, yeah. God favored me. Yeah, yeah, yeah. God favored me. God favors me. God favors me. Whatever the enemy does, God favors me. The favor of God is upon me. Ah, thank you, Jesus. God favors. Yeah, 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 yeah. God favors me. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, God favors me. Yeah, 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 God favors me. Praise God, praise God. We give him praise. Ooh, come on and worship God. Worship the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. He deserves the praise. Me. Amen. We give him the praise. We give him the praise. We give him the glory. We give him the honor. We give him the adoration. Oh, Father, we thank you. We give you all the glory. Adoration, power be unto you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Oh, I give you the praise. We give you the glory. All honor, all adoration be unto you in the name of Jesus. I pray for you right now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, that in every way the enemy attacks your character, in any way the enemy attacks your integrity, in any way the enemy attacks you, whether it's your character or your integrity, whatever way they use to attack you, I pray in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the favor of God will rest upon you in the mighty name of Jesus. The enemy is there to attack you. The enemy is there to attack you. They are there anywhere. They are surrounding you to attack you. They are surrounding your life to attack you. Oh, I pray in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, in any way that the enemy is using or trying his form to attack you, to attack your life, to attack your character, to attack your integrity, I pray one more time, the favor of God, the mercy of God will rest upon you in a terrible way, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The favor of God will rest upon you. God will release favor upon you in the name of Jesus. The power of God will rest upon you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the prosperity of God will rest upon you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The enemy can try, in any way, but he will never succeed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Who is the enemy? Where is the enemy? The enemy within, The Bible says in Micaiah 7 verse 6, for a son treats the father with contempt, and the daughter rises up against her mother. The daughter-in-law rises up against her mother. A man's enemy are the men of his own house. A man's enemy are the men of his own house. And Matthew 10:36 says, a person's enemy will be those of his own household. The people in your household, the people who you eat with and dine with, majority of them are your enemies. Majority of them don't like you. Majority of them want to see somebody go down. Majority of them want to see somebody go down in any way. The Bible says here that, but I say to you, love your enemies and do good to those who hate you. Love your enemies. The Bible didn't ask you to hate them. The Bible says love them. Love your enemies and do good to those who hate you. So if somebody hates you and the person doesn't like you and the person is your enemy, as a child of God, the Bible commands you to show them love. Show them love. The more you are showing them love, the more you are heaping coals of fire on the head of the enemy. That is what you don't understand. And that is what you need to understand. The more you show your enemy love, because you love your enemy and you are following what the Bible asks you to do. The Bible says, love your enemies. Love your enemies. Luke 6:27-36. And do good to those who hate you. So those who hate you, those who don't like you, do good to them. Bless those who curse you. Bless those who curse you. And pray for those who abuse you. To one who strikes you on the cheek, offer him also the other one. And as you wish the others would do unto you, do unto them too. Love your enemies. That's what the Bible says. The more you love your enemies, the more you pray for your enemies, the more you do good to those who hate you, you are heaping coals of fire on the enemy's head. You are heaping coals of fire on the enemy's head because you show him love and he show you hatred. There is coals of fire on his head already. I pray for you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The power and ability that will enable you to do the things that God requires of you. I pray that the power will come upon you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse them. Bless those who persecute you. The Bible says, bless and do not curse them. Because he says, if you carefully obey his voice and do all I say, I will be enemy to your enemies, and I will be adversary to your adversary. As long as you obey the voice of God and you do what God asks you to do, God himself will be enemies to your enemies. It is not for you to fight your enemy. It is for you to show them love. It is for God to revenge on your behalf, not for you to take revenge into your hand. Play your own part and let God play his own part. The more you show your enemy love, the more you show them love, the more the coals of fire is going on the enemy head. The more God will be an enemy to your enemy. Anybody that is your enemy, God will be an enemy to them. For the Bible says that Psalm 35 verse 1 to 28, O Lord, contend with those that contend with me. Fight against those that fight against you. People will contend with you. As a child of God, people will contend with you. As a child of God, people will fight against you. Most especially if you have the calling of God upon your life. The enemies will fight against you. Remember, I told you already, I said in the book of Matthew 10:36, a person's enemy are those of his own household, those that are in your household, those that you see every day. Majority of them are your enemies. Majority of them don't want to see somebody rise up. Majority of them want to go with the covenant of the forefathers, the forefathers' covenant. They want to bring it upon somebody's life, the covenant that they have rectified 27 years ago. When you are not alive, but now that you are alive, they want that covenant to continue renewing itself. I pray and I declare in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, every enemy that want to bring the covenant of the old upon your destiny, I pray that the power of God will render them useless in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. If you carefully obey the voice of the Lord, I will be enemy to your enemy. I will fight against those that fight against you. The Bible says in the book of David said, fight against those that fight against me. Fight against those that fight against me. People will fight against you anywhere you go. The enemy will fight against you. Whether in your dream, they will fight against you. Whatever you do, they will fight against you. I pray and I declare in the name of Jesus, every enemy that fight against you in your dream, the Lord will raise up a banner against them in the mighty name of Jesus. Every enemy that use a clothing cloth to cover up your dream, so that you will not remember the things that God asks you to do. The enemy used a clothing cloth to cover up your dream, so that you will not remember the things that God asks you to do. I pray the fire of God will run them mad in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. For it is not an enemy who taunts me, and I could not bear it. It is not an adversary who deals insolently with me that I could not hide from him. But it is you, O man, my equal, my companion, my familiar friend, my familiar friend. It is not the enemy that taunts you, my brother. It is not the enemy. It is the friend, your familiar friend, the friend that is familiar to you. We used to take sweet counsel together within God's house, and we walked in the throng. The two of you walk together. You eat together. You dine together. The friend is so intimate with you that he can do anything to you. He is very intimate. He's your close friend. You trust him so much. He's so that is the kind of person that the enemy uses. Somebody you trust so dearly too much. Somebody you cannot ever expect to do you harm. The person will be so intimate with you. The person will be so close with you. The person will know everything about you. He will want to know you. He will want to understand you. He will want to get too close to you. He will want to sleep with you. You eat together. You dine together. You do everything together. You even establish business together. Everything you do it together. You establish business to everything that you are doing. You are always doing it together. The time will come when this person will begin to see that the business that you establish together is flourishing. And then suddenly something will enter into his heart. He will want to take everything from himself. He will now try to cook up a plan to kill the person and take everything for himself. The power of the enemy within. The power of the enemy within. The power of the enemy within. But the Bible says this. Matthew 5, verse 44. I say to you, love your enemies. Love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you. Love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you. That's what the Bible says. Love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you. Love your enemies. The more you love your enemies, the more you are heaping coals of fire on their head. Love your enemies and pray for those that persecute you. Love your enemies. Love your enemies and pray for those that persecute you. Love your enemies. That's what the Bible says. Love your enemies. Love your enemies. I pray for you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The power that will enable you to love your enemies. Receive it right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The power to love your enemies. Receive it by fire. In the name of Jesus, the power that will enable you to love your enemies, receive it in the name of Jesus. The power to love your enemies, receive it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father, we give you all the praise. We give you all the glory. We magnify your name, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Let your name be glorified. For the Bible says, I have come to set a man against his father, daughter against his mother, and daughter-in-law against his mother-in-law. Brother will deliver brother unto death. Father, his child. A children will rise against their parents and have them put to death. Eh? For the Bible says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him shall have eternal life. Whosoever believeth in him shall have eternal life. I pray for you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every enemy that wants to bring you down, the Lord will run them mad in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every enemy within that wants to bring you down, the power of God will render them useless in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Sometimes the enemy will give you a clue to do something, but because you fail to do what they ask you to do, because you fail to follow what they ask you to follow, they tend to turn against you and they tend to become your enemy. So they begin to say certain things. Every enemy that does not want you to succeed, every enemy that does not want you to have your own things, to succeed in life, to have success in life, every enemy that does not want you to succeed, the power of God will render them useless in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every enemy that does not want you to succeed, the power of God will render them useless in the name of Jesus. The Bible says, do not love the world or the things in the world. For anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. Do not love the world. But if anyone does not provide for his relative and especially for members of his household, He has denied the faith and is worse than an unbeliever. Do not love the world nor love things in the world. The world will love its own. All you have to do is love Jesus. Take care of Jesus. Hold on to Jesus no matter what happens. No matter what the world says. Hold on to Jesus. The world will go against you in certain things. Hold on to Jesus. He's the only one that can rescue you. He's the only one that can deliver you. He's the only one that can save you from every enemy that want to rise up against you. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every enemy that stand up against you in your household, every enemy that does not want to see you succeed in your household, the power of God will render them useless in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The Bible says it, a man's enemies are those of his household, those that live with you, those that eat with you, they dine with you, they eat your food. They eat your drink. They drink with you. They come to your house and drink. They drink with you. They eat with you. They do everything with you. But yet, they don't want you to succeed. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every enemy that rise up against you, I say the power of God will render them useless. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every enemy that want to use power to cover up your dream, for you not remembering your dream, whatever they have used to cover your dream, for you not to remember, the power of God will destroy it by the blood of the Lamb in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The power of the Holy Ghost will render them useless in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. When a man's ways please the Lord, he will make his enemies to be at peace with him. If your ways please the Lord, the enemy will be at peace with you, whether they like it or not, because your ways please the Lord. Proverbs 16 verse 7. If a man's ways please the Lord, he makes his enemies to be at peace with him, because your ways please the Lord, because your ways are in the ways of the Lord, because you don't dine with them, you don't eat with them, your way is different. What you are doing is different from what the world is doing. You want to stay clear of the things of the world. You want to stay clear of the thing that the world is doing. Therefore, they hate you. Therefore, they don't want to see you. Therefore, they don't want you to succeed. Therefore, they don't want you to finish that house. They don't want you to finish that car. You buy a car, they are angry. You are building a house, they are jealous. Whatever they are doing, they don't like it. Why? Because they don't want to see you succeed. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, every enemy within that want to destroy your destiny, the fire of God will render them useless in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The power of God will render them useless in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every enemy that rise up against you, every enemy that rise up against you, as you are watching my video and listening to my voice, anyone that rise up against you, that say you will not succeed, that say you will not reach your destiny, that say you will not fulfill your destiny, the power of God will render them useless in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The power of God will render them useless in the name of Jesus. The power of God will render them useless in the mighty name of Jesus. Even God will make them to run mad. Do you know that God himself can make somebody to run mad? This is not madness. Madness from the devil. God himself can make somebody run mad. It's in the Bible. I will open it to you. Deuteronomy 28:28. The Lord will smite them with madness. Deuteronomy chapter 28:28. Deuteronomy 28:28. The Lord will smite them with madness, with blindness, and with bewilderment of the heart. It's in your Bible. Every enemy that say you will not rise up, the power of God will smite them with madness, with blindness, and with bewilderment of the heart. I am not the one saying it. It's the word of God. And the Bible says Jesus is the word. He is the beginning and the end. He is the beginning. The word is the word. He is the word. Jesus himself is the word. He spoke the word. He said, let there be light, and there was light. And the light shining, the darkness comprehended it not. I speak word of power and authority. Every enemy that rise up against you, the power of God will strike them with blindness and madness. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, every enemy that rise up against you, the Lord will face them in Jesus' name. The Lord will face them by the power of the Holy Ghost. Daniel 4:28. And this happened to Nebuchadnezzar the king. 12 months later, he was walking on the roof of the palace of Babylon. The king reflected and said, is this not Babylon the great, which I myself built as a royal residence by my power and for the glory of my majesty? Nebuchadnezzar the king rose up against God, and God turned him into something else. Is this not Babylon that I built myself with my great power and the glory of my majesty? Nebuchadnezzar, who rose up against God, the authority, and God turned him, God made him to run mad. God made Nebuchadnezzar to run mad. He ran into the bush. He ran mad. He didn't know what he was doing again. Nebuchadnezzar was mad. He ran completely mad. That is the power of God. The power of God that will set you free from the hand of your enemy. Receive it by the blood of the Lamb in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I pray for you. The power of God shall deliver you. The power of God will set you free from your enemy. The power of God will deliver you. The power of God will set you free. The Bible said in the word, Jesus is the word. He says, speak my word. My word that I speak shall not return back unto you void, but it shall go to fulfill that which has been accomplished. I claim the word and I speak the word according to the Bible that says his word will not return back unto me void, but go to fulfill that which has been accomplished. I speak the word of power and authority into your life as you are listening to the sound of my voice. Every enemy that rise up against you, the fire of God will consume them in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every enemy that rise up against you, that said you will not succeed, that said you will not succeed, that said what happened to your father will happen to you, the power of God will render them useless in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every enemy that stand upon one's useless covenant of the old, every covenant that has happened 25 years ago, and they want to bring that covenant into your life, the power of God will destroy that covenant in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I pray every calabash, every sacrifice from the kingdom of darkness that they are placed at your doorstep, that they want to use to initiate you, every calabash, everything that they want to use to initiate you into their kingdom, every sacrifice that they want to use to initiate you into their kingdom, the power of God render it useless in the name of Jesus. That food that they have placed on the table, that they want to use to initiate you, I pray in the name of Jesus, the power of God render them useless in the name of Jesus. The Bible said, every word I speak shall not return back unto me void, but it shall go to fulfill that which has been accomplished. I follow the word I believe in the word, and I speak the word of power and authority. As you are listening to the sound of my voice, receive the power of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. Whatever they are placed in that sacrifice, let the fire of God consume it in the name of Jesus. The power of God destroy them. The fire of God consume it. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, let the fire of God go ahead of you. As you go out today, the power of God will go ahead of you. In the name of Jesus. The Bible says, Zechariah 12:4, in that day declares the Lord, I will strike every horse with bewilderment, and his rider with madness. Benissa. And I will watch over the house of Judah while I strike every house of the people with blindness. The Lord will strike your enemy with blindness. Every enemy that stand up against you. Every enemy that stand up against your life. Every enemy that said you will not make it in life. Every enemy that want to use one covenant to hold you down. Every enemy that want to use one testimony or one covenant, forefather's generational covenant, to hold down your destiny, to hold down your future. The power of God will destroy it in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The fire of God will consume it by the power of the Holy Ghost in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The power of the enemy within. The enemy has no mercy. The enemy has no mercy. The enemy has no mercy. I pray one more time. Every sacrifice they have placed down at your doorstep. Every sacrifice they have placed down at your place of work that they want to use to initiate you into their kingdom. Makere basata. Holy Ghost fire, consume it. In the name of Jesus. The power of God render it useless. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The fire of God consume it. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The Holy Ghost fire consume them. I send fire right now into the camp of the enemy. I speak according to the word of God that said, every word I speak shall not return back unto me void, but it shall go to fulfill that which has been accomplished. I send fire into the camp of the enemy. Fire that will destroy the plan of the enemy. Fire that will destroy their plan. They conspired. Whatever conspire they conspire against you. Whatever meeting they hold against you to stop you from reaching your destiny. I declare the power of God will favor you. The favor of God will go ahead of you. And their plan shall be destroyed. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Their plans shall be destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus. Their plans shall be destroyed in the name of Jesus. The Lord will strike them with blindness. The Lord will strike them with madness. The Lord will strike them with blindness and madness. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The Lord will remove the mercy upon their life. That mercy that they are using, the power of God will remove it in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The power of God will remove it in the mighty name of Jesus. Jeremiah 25, thus says the Lord God of Israel, because you have sent letters in your own name to all the people who are in Jerusalem and Zarephath, the son of Messiah, the priest to all the priests, the Lord has made you priest instead of Jehoiada the priest to be overseer of the house over every madam who prophesies to put him in the stocks of the iron collar. Now then, why have you not rebuked Jeremiah of Anota who prophesies to you? Why have you not rebuked him? Why? That's what the Bible says. The days of punishment have come. The days of retribution have come. The days of punishment have come. The days of retribution have come. Hosea 9 verse 7 to 8. The days of retribution have come. The inspired man is demented because of the grossness of your iniquity.
because of the grossness of your iniquity, the iniquity of the wicked man, the iniquity of that wicked man in your household that want to destroy your destiny, that wicked man in your household that want to make you are shameful, because of the grossness of your iniquity and because of your hostility is so great. Ephraim was a watchman with his word and prophet, yet a snare of the bird catcher is all in his ways, and there is only hostility in the house of his God. There is only hostility in the house of his God. Only hostility in the house of his God. There is only hostility in the house of his God. I pray for you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I declare and I pray by the power of the anointing that breaks every yoke that the enemy placed upon your life, every yoke that the enemy placed upon your destiny, every yoke that the enemy wants to use, that cloven cloth that when you have a dream, you cannot remember. You cannot remember the dream. The enemy has used something to cover up the dream. When you take a cloth and you use the cloth to cover up a fan, you cannot see the fan. The fan is under the cloth. Unless you remove the cloth, that's when you can see the fan. In the spirit realm, the enemy has used a cloth to cover up your dream. That's why sometimes when you dream, you cannot remember. I pray in the name of Jesus, every cloven cloth the enemy has used to cover up your dream, I destroy it by fire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I destroy them by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. I come against you by the power of the blood of the Lamb in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. That thing that the enemy has used to surround you, to stop you from getting an helper. They don't want you to receive your helper. They don't want you to enter into the room of help. When you go into the room of help, that is when you get an helper. But inside the room of help, there is a man, a strong man at the door. I pray in the name of Jesus, that strong man at the door, that strong man at the door, I consume them with fire in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I pray, enter into the room of help. Receive help now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every power of the enemy, let it be destroyed in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every power of the enemy, let them be destroyed by the blood of the Lamb in the name of Ephesians 9 verse 3. There is an evil under the sun, and there is no faith for men. Furthermore, the hearts of the Son of Man are full of evil. The Bible says the heart of man is desperately wicked. The heart of man is desperately wicked. Everybody thinking of wickedness every day. How to destroy you? How to make this? How to make that? Why is it that human being is always thinking of how to destroy? You are not thinking of how to construct something. Look at these white men, what they do. They construct things. They think of what they can do with their mind, how to make things constructive. But somebody is thinking how to destroy. Even in the Bible, it has been like that since generation, that people have been destroying one another. Brother rise against brother. Sister rise against sister. Nephew rise against nephew. Two friends rise against one another. Too intimate friend, intimate friend. The enemy will come so intimate to you that he will make you to trust him so much that he cannot deny you. It is that kind of person you have to be careful of. The enemy within, they will be so close to you. They will be so intimate to you. They will eat with you. They will dine with you. They will sleep with you. You will trust them so much that you will handle all your life into their care. And at the end of the day, it is this particular kind of person that is doing you. That's why the Bible says that a man's enemy is from his household. It's in your Bible. A man's enemy is, go and check your household very well. There's an enemy there who is tormenting that person. There's an enemy in the household. There's an enemy in the household. I pray in the name of Jesus, every enemy in your household that want to destroy your destiny, every enemy in your household that want to see you suffer, that want to see you suffer, the power of God will render them useless in the name of Jesus. The power of God Lord, we go ahead and strike them with blindness, strike them with madness in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The power of the enemy. The power of the enemy. The enemy that has no mercy. The enemy that wants to achieve his aim. Enemy will always be enemy. They can never repent. They will never repent. They can only say, sorry. I'm sorry, brother. I didn't know. I'm sorry. It's the work of the devil. It's a trick. Oh, they want to trick you. They are going to come in again in another way to catch you. If you are not vigilant and open your eyes very well, they will come in again in another way. So anybody who is an enemy, stay away from them. Stay away completely. Don't be friends with them, because their plan is to bring that person down. Their plan is to destroy that person's future. I declare in the name of Jesus, every enemy that is standing against you, that doesn't want you to be successful in life, that doesn't want you to reach your destiny in life, I break their plan in the name of Jesus. The Bible says, whenever they come together to make a decision, it's in the Bible, I'm reading this offhand, whenever they come together to make a decision, it shall not stand, because God is with us. If God be for us, who can be against us? Let them come together to make that decision. It shall not stand. It shall not stand. Because God is on your side. If God is on your side, let them surround you in billions of places. Let them surround you round the table. Let them be billions of... The fire of God will consume all of them completely. And there will be dead corpses on the brain. There will be dead corpses. 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 In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I pray for you by the power of the Holy Ghost. Receive the power of the Holy Ghost in the mighty name of Jesus. The power that will make you to outshine the enemy. The power that will make you to outshine the enemy. The power that will make you to be successful in life. Receive it by the blood of the Lamb. In the mighty name of Jesus, I speak with authority. The Bible said, every word I speak will not return back unto me void. It shall go to fulfill that which has been accomplished. Jesus was the first person who spoke the word before the devil existed. The Bible said, in the beginning, in the book of Genesis, in the beginning, God was the word. So Jesus spoke the word before the devil spoke the word. If Jesus spoke the word before the devil, it means the power of the word of Jesus is greater than that of the devil. I use the power that Jesus spoke into your life in the book of Genesis, and I declare upon your life, receive the power of the Holy Ghost that will make you to be successful, that will make you to achieve your aim over the plan of the devil in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every enemy within your household, let them conspire against you. They will be destroyed by fire. I send fire into their camp in the name of Jesus. That sacrifice that they are using to control you, that remote control that they are using to control your mind, that they are carrying up using to control my mind, your mind, I consume it by the power of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The power of the Holy Ghost go ahead of you. Favor of God go ahead of you. The mercy of God go ahead of you. The Spirit of God go ahead of you. In the name of Jesus, as you go into this new week, the fire of God go ahead of you. Mercy of God go ahead of you. Favor of God go ahead of you. Everything that God made go ahead of you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you will be successful in everything you do. You will be successful in the name of Jesus. The enemy will not have power over you. The enemy will not have power over you. The enemy will not have power over you. Every enemy that tried to rise up against you, the ground will open up their mouth and swallow them up in the name of Jesus. The Bible said, Korah and Datah rose up against Moses. Korah and Datta rose up against Moses. They said, who are you that God should go before you? Who are you? Who are you by the way? Moses was the one that was called. But Korah and Datta rose up against him. They didn't want him to plan. They didn't want him to succeed. But the ground opened up his mouth. Rakeba Karabasanta. And swallowed them up. They were dead corpses because they rose up against Moses. Everyone that rise up against you, the ground will swallow them up in the name of Jesus. The power of the ground will swallow them up in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The power of the ground will swallow them up in the name of Jesus. The power of the Most High God will consume them in the name of Jesus. For the Bible says our God is a consuming fire. Jehovah Shalom is a consuming fire. Jehovah Jireh is a consuming fire. Jehovah Nissi is a consuming fire. He will consume them in the name of Jesus. He will consume them in the name of Jesus. He will consume them in the name of Jesus. There is an evil under the sun. Furthermore, the hearts of the Son of Man are full of evil and insanity in their heart throughout their lives. Afterwards, they go to the dead. They go to the dead. Their heart is full of evil and insanity. Their heart is full of evil and insanity. Every day, they are always thinking of evil. Every day they are always going to that babalawo. Every day they are always looking for ways. I pray for you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every enemy that has taken your picture, they have taken your picture to that man to cook up on it. They are looking at you in the water. They are looking at you in the water. They are looking at you in the glass. They are looking at you with that stupid bloody red cloth that they are using. Whatever they are using to look at you from the spirit realm, I destroy them by fire. I send fire to it in the name of Jesus. I break that glass by the fire of the Holy Ghost. I destroy that water. The Bible said our God is a consuming fire. That evil water that they are using to look at you, I consume that water. I send fire into their camp. Let the fire of God consume them. Let the ground open up its mouth and swallow all of them up in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The power of the enemy, I break their chain in the name of Jesus. I break their chain in the name of Jesus. Every enemy in your household who does not want you to succeed, how dare every enemy in your household, they don't want you to succeed. You are building a house, they have problem. You buy a car, it's a problem. Everything you do is a problem. You give them money, it's a problem. But yet, they are looking for how to bring the person down. But yet, they come to you and they smile at you. Hey, brother, today, you are very good. Oh, it's very nice. Oh, you know, I've been thinking of that thing as well. But yet, deep inside their heart is full of bitterness and poison towards you. They don't love you at all. They don't love you at all. They don't love you at all. I pray for you one more time. Every enemy that his heart is full of bitterness and poison to you, towards you, the fire of God will go ahead and destroy them. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, every enemy within, they come to you. They come to you as a friend, but yet they are an enemy. They smile at you as a friend, but yet they are your enemy. They eat with you as a friend, but yet they are your enemy. Everything they do with you, they do it with you as a friend, but yet they want to bring that person down. They want to destroy that person's life. They want to make him suffer. They want to make him suffer. They want to make him suffer. Every power of the enemy that want to make you suffer, as you are hearing the sound of my voice, the power of God will scatter them in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. No mercy for the enemy. The enemy has no mercy for you. And you want to show him mercy. His plan is to destroy somebody. If he can kill the person, he will kill the person. Waste them before they waste you. Waste them before they waste you. Waste them completely before they waste you. I pray for you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Every plan of the enemy on your life shall be scattered by the power of the Holy Ghost. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I give you the glory. I give him the praise in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The favor of God will go ahead of you. Every enemy, you heard what the song were. They whispered. They whispered. The enemy whispered against you. The enemy conspired against you. That's the song, the first song I sang in the praise and worship. Go and listen to it. The enemy conspired against you. They whispered against you. But yet, what happened? God favored you. They conspired and whispered. They planned. They did everything that they could do. They walked around. They made their concussion stronger. You know, go walk. They made their concussion stronger. They united together. They united their forces, their powers together. They brought all their powers together to combine them together to make it stronger. But yet, God favored you. God favored me. It didn't work. It didn't work. Because the power of God, nobody can sustain it. The power of God is greater. No enemy can move the power of God. If God be for you, who can be against you? Why do you have to be afraid of the enemy? Why do you have to be afraid of that concussion that they are making? That concussion that they are making cannot do you any harm. Cannot do you any good. Because he that is with you is greater than he that is in the world. He that is standing with you, he that is standing with me, is greater than he that is in the world. You are in the world. The person I'm directing my speech to is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. The Jehovah Shalom, the Jehovah Jireh is your master. He is your master. He is the master of the devil. He is the one that created the devil. He is the one that made the devil. So if he created the devil, how will the devil have power over him? It's not possible. It's not possible. Every enemy that want to destroy your destiny, the power of God will send them to the grave. The power of resurrection will scatter them and send them to the grave in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I give you all the glory. I give you all the praise. I magnify your name, King of Kings and Lord of Lords, omnipotent God. Ever present God in time of trouble, I give you all the glory. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Glory, power, honor, adoration be unto you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we pray. Amen, amen, amen. We give him the praise once again. We worship him. We exalt his name. We magnify his name because his name is El Shaddai. He has so many names. El Shaddai, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, A to Z. So many names in the Bible. So many, you can call him whatever name you want to call him. How many names does the devil has? That is where God is greater than the enemy. How many names can you call Satan? He's only known as Satan, demon, Satan. But look at all the names of God. Jehovah Yahweh, Jehovah Shalom, Jehovah Nissi, El Shaddai, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, omnipotent, ever-present God. He has so many names. You can call him as many names as possible. But how many names does the devil have? The devil doesn't have any name. He just call him devil. Devil is devil. But you can call God in any name you want to name him, and he will answer you. That is how you need to know that the power of God is greater than that of the devil. He that is with you, he that is with me, is greater than he that is in the world. The world will love his own. But because you are of Jesus, that's why the world hates you. Whether the world hates you or not, continue to do the things that you are doing. Continue to serve God. Continue to worship him. Continue to exalt his name. Continue to magnify his name. The world will hate you. The world will stand against you, but they will never overcome. They will never win. They will never overcome. They can do what they like. They will never overcome. Because God that is with you is greater than he that is in the world. We thank God once again for another day. We give him all the praise. We magnify your name. We give him all the glory, all the honor, all the adoration in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Thank you for the power of the blood. Thank you for the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. If you want to give your life to Jesus, you can give your life to Jesus now. If you have been doing things wrong in the past and you are backslided, if you have been doing things wrong, or if you have not even heard about the name of Jesus, give your life to Jesus now before it is too late. Because you never know, anything can happen tomorrow. Anything can happen tomorrow. Give your life to Jesus now before it is too late. Give your life to Jesus. If you are backslided, give your life to Jesus. Surrender everything unto him and he will take care of you. He will take care of you. He will supply all your need. And the Bible says it. I will supply your need according to his riches in Christ's glory, Jesus. He will supply all your need. What is that need that you want that God cannot supply? He will supply everything completely. And you will be shocked and surprised that Jesus can supply all your need according to his riches in Christ's glory. So when you say according to his riches, he can even make you rich. He can even make you rich. Amen. Proverbs 10 verse 22. Only the blessing of God can make you rich. Open your Bible there. Proverbs 10 verse 22. It's only the blessing of God that can make you rich. You want to be rich and successful, you need the blessing of God in your life. That is the only way you can be rich. If you want to give your life to Jesus now, close your eyes and say these words after me. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I come to you today in the name of Jesus. I surrender my life to you. I have not been quite right in the things I have been doing. I have not loved you with all my heart. I have not loved my neighbors as myself. Have mercy upon me, Lord. I surrender my life to you right now. And I make a U-turn in the name of Jesus. Accept me as your personal Lord and accept me into your kingdom, Lord. And let your name be glorified. In Jesus' anointed name we pray. Amen. Brother, if you made that verse, so if you spoke that word, heaven is rejoicing over you right now that you have just given your life to Jesus. For the Bible says, anyone that gives his life to Jesus, there's rejoicing in heaven. I thank God for your life, brother, that you have just given your life to Jesus. Every time you give your life to Jesus, it's not good to give your life to Jesus every time. You only give your life to Jesus once. Once you have given your life to Jesus. Maybe there is somebody else online who has not given his life to Jesus or who has not yet heard about the name of Jesus. I pray in the name of Jesus, as you hear this message and listen to this message, it is better for you to give your life to Jesus now so that you don't die in your sin and go to hellfire. I pray for you in the name of Jesus, the power that will enable you to give your life to Jesus, the power of the Holy Ghost, it will rest upon you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Thank you very much. God bless you. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you his peace now and forevermore in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Thank you for all those who are watching. Thank you very much, Mr. Oteshile Olanrewaju. Thank you for watching. The Lord bless you in Jesus' name. The Lord will make you to prosper in Jesus' name. Whatever you lay your hand upon shall prosper in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. You will ride on and ride on and ride on in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Everything you do shall be successful. Everywhere you go, there will be success. When you go out, you are blessed. When you come in, you are blessed. At your home, you are blessed. At your place of work, you are blessed. Everything you do, you are blessed. In the name of Jesus, I declare blessing of God into your life right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Receive it by fire in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Thank you everyone for watching. The Lord bless you. The Lord give you all the praise. The Lord continue to bless you and guide you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Shall we say the grace together? May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with us and remain with us now and forevermore. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen, amen, Amen. God bless you. Thank you for listening. Thank you very much for listening. The Lord bless you. Until another time, stay blessed. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you very much. Bye for now. Thank you very much. Bye for now. Thank you. Bye.